Welcome to Introduction to Healthcare and Public Health in the U.S., Delivering Healthcare Part 2. This is Lecture C. The component Introduction to Healthcare and Public Health in the U.S. is a survey of how healthcare and public health are organized and how services are delivered in the U.S. It covers public policy, relevant organizations and their interrelationships, professional roles, legal and regulatory issues, and payment systems. It also addresses health reform initiatives in the U.S. The learning objectives for Delivering Healthcare Part 2 are to describe the organization of clinical healthcare delivery in the outpatient setting and the organization of outpatient healthcare. Describe the organization of ancillary healthcare delivery in the outpatient setting and discuss the role of different healthcare providers with an emphasis on the delivery of care in an interdisciplinary setting. This lecture will discuss retail clinics, urgent care centers, and the emergency department as outpatient venues for healthcare. One venue for obtaining outpatient healthcare is a retail clinic. Retail clinics are often located within stores or pharmacies, although they may also be freestanding. They are usually staffed by nurse practitioners who are nurses with additional training, also known as mid-level providers. Retail clinics are intended to treat common and minor illnesses such as sore throats, uncomplicated urinary tract infections, conjunctivitis, also known as pink eye, or simple sprains. Urgent care centers offer a level of care that is more acute and more sophisticated than that offered by retail clinics. There are more than 8,500 acute care centers in the U.S., and this trend has been growing since the 1970s. Urgent care centers are usually walk-in clinics, which means that a patient does not need to have an appointment to see a provider. Providers in urgent care centers are frequently physicians, but may also be mid-level providers, such as physician assistants and nurse practitioners. These centers may have extended hours and usually provide care for acute illnesses and injuries that are beyond the scope of care of a typical primary care practice. Urgent care centers typically have laboratories or X-ray facilities on site, and some of them also have more advanced diagnostic equipment. However, urgent care centers are not intended to treat life-threatening emergencies. The emergency department of a hospital is best equipped to address life-threatening conditions. This slide provides some statistics on the emergency department, or ED, which may also be called the emergency room, or ER. The number of people using emergency rooms has increased over time. In 2006, there were 119 million ED visits. In 2011, there were over 136 million. That equals about 259 visits to emergency rooms every minute during 2011. In 2006, 12.8% of ED visits resulted in admission to the hospital. In 2011, that percentage dropped slightly to 11.9%. The majority of patients waited 15 to 59 minutes to see a provider. Emergency rooms are intended to treat life-threatening emergencies, but a substantial number of ED visits are not for emergencies. Approximately 11% of all ambulatory medical care visits in the U.S. occurred in the emergency department in 2008, and the number of non-emergency ED visits may be very high. For example, in 2010, it was estimated that between 13.7 and 27.1% of all emergency department visits could have been treated at an urgent care or retail clinic with a potential savings of approximately $4.4 billion. The sheer number of people who are seen in emergency departments in the U.S. has led to overcrowding. Overcrowding in the ED is associated with delays in the treatment of serious medical conditions, such as heart attacks or strokes. Overcrowding also increases waiting times for people with minor illnesses and reduces the promptness and the quality of pain management for people with acute pain. Patients who are admitted to the hospital may be boarded in the hallways while waiting for rooms to open up. Ambulances may be diverted from full emergency departments toward more distant facilities that are able to take in patients. Finally, overcrowding decreases physicians' productivity within emergency departments. All of these are significant issues, and the problem is only getting worse. So, why are there so many emergency room visits? In an example from upstate New York, 45% of potentially unnecessary ER cases occurred between 9 a.m. and 5 p.m. This means that the hours of operation of primary care clinics are not necessarily the issue. In fact, the statistics suggest that patients simply cannot be seen in primary care clinics between 9 a.m. and 5 p.m., and therefore they seek care in emergency rooms. Could this be a consequence of the primary care crisis discussed in the previous lecture? There are many reasons why patients with non-emergency medical issues choose to seek care in emergency departments. Some patients do not have a primary care provider. Many primary care clinicians are overextended, and there is a shortage of primary care providers. Patients who lack medical insurance find it difficult to go through the system of primary care clinics, so lack of insurance is often a barrier to care. Patients on Medicaid may seek emergency care more often than those with private insurance coverage or the uninsured because of higher rates of disability and chronic medical conditions. The growing trend of patients receiving non-emergency primary care services from the emergency department rather than relying on primary care clinics is troubling because the cost of providing care in the emergency department is far greater than the cost of delivering identical healthcare services in the setting of the primary care clinic. Therefore, inappropriate ED visits are driving up the cost of healthcare in the U.S. in general. One important strategy for reducing the number of inappropriate ED visits is patient education. A patient who is aware of the ramifications of inappropriate ED visits and the financial burden associated with these visits is less likely to use EDs inappropriately. Primary care clinics need to be able to provide comprehensive services, especially for patients with complex medical issues or chronic illnesses who tend to use the emergency department. Primary care physicians can coordinate a patient's care longitudinally and comprehensively by establishing patient-centered medical homes. Sometimes patients do not know whether it is more appropriate for them to go to the primary care clinic or to the emergency department. This problem could be avoided with a telephone triage system, where nurses can direct callers to the appropriate healthcare setting. Another effort should be to improve the availability of after-hours care with extended hours in primary care clinics, convenience care centers, or even urgent care centers to reduce the level of utilization of emergency departments after office hours. Inappropriate ED visits could also be reduced by increasing enrollment in safety net programs. Health information is often complex, and patients sometimes find it difficult to care for themselves. But if health information were simplified, patients may be able to better care for themselves and avoid going to the emergency department in the first place. This completes Lecture C of Delivering Healthcare, Part 2. In summary, this lecture discussed retail clinics, urgent care centers, and the emergency department as venues for healthcare. The problems and possible solutions for overcrowded emergency departments were reviewed.